Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalam-o-alikuM. Welcome back to amfahhtech YouTube channel. This is Sayyida Azra and I'm back with one more useful video. Today we are going to learn how to make attractive and professional thumbnails for YouTube videos easy, fast and free. Thumbnails are one of the most critical elements to ranking your content. Without an attractive thumbnail, you won't grab the attention of your potential viewers. If you're new here, make sure you click the subscribe button, hit the bell icon so that you will get notification of upcoming videos. Fortunately, there are many free ways to easily create effective thumbnails. Today, I'm gonna use Canva because it's so simple to get great results fast and it's completely free. So let's jump into it. Open browser, go to canva.com. Canva is basically a free app. A website that you can use on your iOS or Android. I use it on my laptop. Let me tell you one thing here, that this video is not sponsored by Canva in any way. I'm recommending you because I use it myself. This tool or website is not only used for creating thumbnails but also for presentations, video editing and many more. But as we are covering YouTube thumbnails today, so we searched YouTube thumbnail here. And we get so many available templates. You can use them as it is or you can change as per your wish. You can see there is a bunch of templates, layout designs available. Let's see this. Remember, all these templates are not free, some of them are paid. Let's see this design. You can use this template as it is or you can modify as per your wish. First, let's make the design completely from scratch, and in the end I will tell you and show you how to modify these ready-made templates available in Canva. This video gonna be very interesting, so watch this video till the end. First, I will add a new page and delete this template. First thing we're gonna do is to add a background. Click elements, search for background. As you see, there is a bunch of options available for backgrounds. Select any background of your choice. I choose this one. Simply you can click on the image or you can drag and drop. Now if you want a thumbnail with your picture, take your picture and you can upload it in the Canva and use it. But I'm searching a picture from the Canva. So for this, go to elements and search woman, as I want a female picture. If you scroll down, you will see a lot of options here. Choose image, click on it again, that will bring it into the project here. I want this one with the background. I'm going to remove the background of the image here. Click image. Click edit image. I use this background removal option from the Canva. It's done. See, this is so simple. You can scale it up and down like this. Then now I want a border around the cutouts of the image. I'm doing a trick for this. Right click on the image. You can do copy paste or simply duplicate the image. Click edit image. Click adjust. Increase the contrast. Increase saturations. Increase highlights. All the options I will increase to maximum, to 100, and this black option I will decrease to minimum because I want the white border around the image. You see, it's done. Increase the size of the white image and position it at the back. For this, I do right click on the image, click layer, Click Send Back. The next thing I wanna do is to add in rectangle, choose elements and search for rectangle. Select rectangle of your choice. You can change color and size and rotate it a little. I'm gonna change color of the box. The next thing I wanna do is to add in some text. So click text, I'll type in create. You can change font, make it bigger. Here you will get a lot of options for fonts. I choose a font here. You can make it bold, italic. You can add effects on text as per your wish. You can change the color of the text. Select box and text. We can actually group them together. Once they are grouped, we can do things like move it around, scale it up, rotate them together, etc. Select the image or you can ungroup them. Then we can edit these two separately. You can also bring in other graphics and things like arrows. Select it. Right here you click the flip and then flip horizontal. Scale it down. And you can adjust the position. Add this element, scale it down, put it down in the bottom left corner. Then I need a YouTube logo. For that we go here in photos and search YouTube. And also, I want to add a logo of my channel. Select. You can resize it. So as you see, it's a creative process. You can also do whatever you want. You can, as I want to change the background. Now you see, it's look better now. Go here to download, select the option from here and click download. See, it was so easy to make a thumbnail from Canva. And now in the last, I'm gonna show you how to edit ready-made templates available in the Canva. I'm using this template. First, I remove this photo because I'm going to create a faceless thumbnail. I'm just rearranging the setting. Now I need a logo of Canva. For that, here in the element, search Canva. This is how it looks. I hope you like this video. For more videos, hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon so that you will be notified every time I post new videos. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.